Would you ever fight Conor McGregor again? Is that the biggest pain? I know you're the biggest paid guy, but is that the biggest attraction? If Floyd Mayweather says, I'll fight anybody, what would be the biggest shit in the world?
Well, I'm a businessman now. You know, I already proved years and years ago that I was the best, period. I'm talking about pound for pound. I already proved all that. So you know, at my age now, I'm a businessman. So I'm not going to be out there competing and fighting guys that only got a small city behind them. Like, you know, you got a lot of American fighters, good, but they got little cities behind them. I'm going to fight guys that got a whole country behind them. So I know I can demand and get what I want to get.
So that's Pacquiao?
I made more with McGregor.
Let me ask you a question.
Hold up. Once again, my faculties and everything that I got comes first. We just talked about your health is your wealth. You know, and that's why I got this towel on. I was working out today. Now, Pacquiao fight because he have to.
I know that.
Once again, I fight if I want to. So there's a difference.
The question is, let me go back to this because it's really important. And I'm only going to big you up with this. I've always wondered, and everybody always said, why Floyd ain't fight Pacquiao at his prime? Why they wasn't in they both their prime? I've always heard a rumor that you just didn't want to get no money. You didn't want to give no money to Bob and Aaron. I heard you, when he tried to take advantage of you, allegedly, when you was younger, and
yes,
you worked your way out that contract, and then you became your own boss from there on and wound up becoming the billionaire that we know. Could you elaborate? Was that the main reason why you didn't fight Pacquiao at your prime at the same time?
Well, y'all, we keep on saying at our prime. I'm older than Pacquiao by 2 years. So we keep on saying in your prime. So when I beat Pacquiao, they say he wasn't in his prime. I'm older than you.
Your health is your wealth. Yeah? So when Fat Joe asked him, would you ever fight Pacquiao? He said, my faculties matter more than anything. Then he was saying about, I will fight guys that have countries behind them, not cities. I'm going to be all over the place with this shit, all right? All over. This is the all over video, okay? I'm moving from here to there. I might pause it. I might work. I might do this. Whatever. Just catch up with me, all right? So what he's saying, he only fight people that have countries behind them. And then he said something about, well, me and Oscar, we was the same age. Me and Pacquiao, I'm older than Pacquiao. We the same age. Yes, you're right. You are the same age era. But why is it back then you couldn't fight Manny Pacquiao at his prime? Why couldn't you? Maybe because the style you had couldn't catch up to Manny Pacquiao's speed. Maybe that's just opinion, right? And you wanted him to slow down. So the age don't matter, because if the age matter, what about right now? Manny Pacquiao got a whole country behind him, yes? And yes, you did made, so you said made more with McGregor, but what's going on with McGregor? Is McGregor want to fight you again? Because right now I'm hearing that you looking for Khabib or something. Yeah, he have a country behind him. So what happened to McGregor? I mean, I don't know. I think Manny Pacquiao and McGregor is in the same kind of business corporation or whatever. Okay, I'm sorry, man. I got to catch up to all this shit because I've been very busy with other things. And the way I see it, if the shit ain't signed, sealed, delivered, I'm not going to be tit for tat for every fucking boxer that's not doing anything that's not signed, sealed, delivered, right? But I'm catching up on a couple of things, but I'm listening, okay? So the way I see it, if y'all was all in your prime, something that Manny Pacquiao at that time, you wasn't ready for. Your defensive style wasn't ready for that speed. So you said, let him slow down. Let's see some flaws in him. you know, or this is a big fight. This will be a become a big fight, which it did, made a lot of money, right? But if age does not matter, why are you talking about your faculties? And health is wealth. If you're trying to have a country behind you from your opponent to make all the money, well, hey, let's do it again. Let's run it back. I see a lot of people bitching and crying now about Wilder and Fury, and that fight not might happen next because the other side, Fury's side, is making all kind of fucking excuses and shit. Not trying to give Wilder a rematch, right? Or whatever. Whatever. Verona, whatever it is. If it ain't done by this December, he must move on and keep busy. I don't know what it is. But that's the same way I felt when it's Mayweather and Pacquiao. Run it back. Even if there's no belts, y'all champions, y'all icons, run it back. But your faculties, your health is your wealth. So what you're saying, you don't want to get your head busted open. You don't want to feel that punch from Manny Pacquiao. Right? Right? So you rather have a opponent get it together, nigga, with a country behind them, right? But an easy work, because you're a businessman. All right, so I see how that's going. I see how that's going, right? Then you said that I don't have to fight. Manny Pacquiao has to fight. Well, what did y'all mean by that? Manny Pacquiao has to fight. Because Manny Pacquiao don't have the money that you have? Is that what you're saying? Well, let's go for tit for tat. Okay, let's go for tit for tat. Manny Pacquiao do not have to fight. It's his passion to fight. Right? Maybe you got more money than him. Fine. But you're not a senator. Maybe you have more money than him. Fine. But you can't be a president of your country. You can't be a president of your country. But Manny Pacquiao can. So this man, regardless if he has a certain level of money, it's not he's fighting because he have to. That's the proof in the pudding. That's you. He's fighting because he's passionate about it. And if you see another interview, which I'm going to flip on that side, he said, the interviewer asked him, is Mayweather your last fight and you're going to retire? This is when he was about to fight Broner. And the interviewer, I'm going to show you the video, show you proof. And he said, nah, Mayweather is not my last fight. And this was in 2019.
What's that feeling? Yeah.
Now, after all the titles you've won, money you've made, what motivates you to keep boxing now when you don't really need
to? I said, that's the evidence of being passionate about this sport. You know what I'm talking about? That's the evidence of being passionate at this sport. That's the real passion, you know. Of course, I am a senator of the Republic of the Philippines. If you and me, if you think, I don't need to box. I have to focus on as a senator of the Republic of the Philippines. But, you know, I want to box. I want to continue because boxing is my passion. You know, but being public service is my mission, so it's a different way. That's why I'm still here, and I'm happy giving honor to my country and, of course, entertain people.
Because you are so passionate, though, is there a concern that you might stay around too long for one too many fights?
All that is, have that in my mind. Stay too long or burning yourself in this sport. I'm thinking about that, you know. When are you gonna stop? Until you feel something in your body? No. I mean, but right now I'm good. I can still fight.
So what's the best case scenario? If obviously I know you're not looking past Broner and you've got this fight coming up, but assuming you win, how do you see your career ending? I mean, if you did get the Floyd fight, would you retire after that? Or
not yet.
Wow.
I want to have a fight. My dream is I want to have a fight. My last fight held in my country. See
how good way to go out. Everybody, is there a stadium big enough to hold that fight?
Oh, we have a stadium, a Philippine arena. Philippine Airlines will accommodate how many? 60,000.
Oh, wow. What would you like for the opponent to be there in the Philippines?
I don't care.
Manny, you talk.
Right? So, he said this in 2019. This is not my last fight. Mayweather won't be my last fight, regardless if I win or lose, right? He's not my last fight. And he said also where he won his last fight. Where do he want his last fight? In the Philippines. So if you hear Manny Pacquiao say, listen, I want to fight in the Philippines. Well, guess what? That's an indicator that he's going to fucking retire. All right? Unless something like this coronavirus is going on and it's affecting his country and he have to do his senator duties, well, I can understand if he retires because of certain situations. This situation happened to everybody, so things might change. But don't underestimate the man, because the man did say this in 2019 that after Mayweather, I'm still going to fight, and he's passionate about it. Not because he needs money, just like you can't be president of United States for United States of America. You can't. But he can. So what does that make him? Better than you? So what you saying? When you can make more money than him, so you better than him. Right? The man could fight if he wants to because he's passionate about it. Simple. Okay, now, let's move on to Spence. Now, this Twitter or IG, whatever the fuck it is, right? He said, well, to come to think about it, yeah, Manny Pacquiao did duck me. I was in the ring. When the fuck did you stop thinking, bro? When did you stop thinking? When did you just start thinking? All of a sudden, you know when you start thinking, you ready to open your mouth and say some shit? When you have a fight with Danny Garcia, signed, sealed, and delivered. Now, all of a sudden, you're thinking. And you ready to promote your fight on the back of Manny Pacquiao. Case closed on that one. Case closed on that one. Because you had a whole heap of time to think about that and say that. Instead, you have your followers saying all that bullshit. And now you late to the party. Now all of a sudden, you want to say it. Where you have all your other followers saying that same sob story about he was in the ring with me. And he was just there. And everybody thought that Mikey Garcia was going to beat you. Manny Pacquiao did not think that Mikey Garcia was going to beat you. Come on, man. Mikey Garcia coming up to your weight, and you think that this man's, you think Manny Pacquiao's ABC 1-2-3. What the fuck is going on here? Manny Pacquiao's a chess player, like I said. He's sitting, he watching. And like I said to myself, if I was Manny Pacquiao, I would have saved your ass for last. I would have saved your ass for last. Yes, I would have gone for Keith, right? And then after that, I would have let you and Crawford fight, but that ain't going to happen, right? And then I would have fought your ass. But instead, it didn't happen that way, okay? The way I see it, man, Spence, you saying a whole lot of shit now after you got your signed, sealed, delivered fight with Danny Garcia. It's a little bit too late, all right? You're being wrong and strong now, but it could have been like that all that time, but you ain't say a shit. I ain't hear a peep from your ass. Now, Crawford, Bob Arum was talking about there might be a fight in the Bubble Stadium or whatever the fuck, with Kell Brook. Do I have a problem with that at this moment with this Verona? No, I don't. Whatever. Because he can't get shit being under Bob Arum. Just being honest right now. Okay? But Bob Arum said that the negotiations with Manny Pacquiao is still on, and they're not sure as yet. What I think about it? Hey, I don't got nothing to think about. Just like Spence said. Spence said in one of his videos, after watching the Wilder and Tyson Fury fight, walking down the aisle, heading home, he said, Kell Brook versus Bud? That count don't mean shit. I whip Kell Brook ass. So if Spence thinking this at that time, when he was walking down the aisle, right? And he said, and? That's not gonna prove nothing. Hey, what is it gonna prove? Bob Arum, you're better off getting a fight with Manny Pacquiao. But, like I said, the negotiations, it's gotta need some compromising on both sides, right? You need compromising on both sides. The way I see it, $20 million for Manny Pacquiao. You might have to negotiate that, Manny Pacquiao. Just the other, I'm seeing negotiations with Timo Lopez and Lomachenko. I'm sorry, I'm not very good pronouncing words when I'm, you know, I don't care, right? And Lomo's saying I'll take a price cut. Listen, Manny Pacquiao, are you passionate of the sport? Sometimes you gotta let shit go. You might have to take a couple millions cut, right? But the way I see it, there's nothing out there right now that could be made. I'm still waiting for shit to be made. So it's either Kell Brook fight Crawford, or it's Pacquiao fight Crawford. That's it. So I'm all over again. So I'm back on Mayweather's ass. So let me ask you something, Mayweather. You're a businessman. Well, why don't you do like George Foreman and make a grill? Okay? Why are you pump faking and teasing people about you coming back to fight McGregor? Next thing you know, I remember it was fucking, you're supposed to fight McGregor and Khabib the same day and charge $200 for this virus. Now I hear McGregor. Yo, it's so funny, yo. This shit is like fucking, listen. If Manny Pacquiao wanted to fight Mikey, he would have done it a long time. Why did it go from Mikey Garcia to Triple G, I mean to Terrence Crawford? I'm trying to get it all together. Triple G, who else? Yeah, because he went to Terrence Crawford because he made, like I said, I'm going to say it over and over again, like everybody likes to say how Marquez knocked out Manny Pacquiao. Second time, Bob Arum blocked the fight. So he went back to Bob Arum and said, let's make that same negotiations that's going on now, that Terrence Crawford might go with Kell Brook, but Bob Arum said, well, the negotiations are still going on what Manny Pacquiao, which might become in the future, we never know. Because right now on that side of Manny Pacquiao, everything is quiet, right? But at the same time, it was Mikey, Triple G, Crawford. It's like we all going to circuit now. It's going all the way back to Mikey Garcia again. So, and like I said, I don't have no problem with him fighting Mikey Garcia. Listen, do you have a problem with Kell Brook fighting Bud? What do we get out of that? Well, it's a common fight that Spence had, right? He had a fight with Kell Brook. Well, the only thing I'll get out of that is that if Bud fights Kell Brook, it's a common fighter that they fought, and I can see, I can equal it out. And that's the same thing when I say when Spence fought Mikey, and I have no problem with Manny Pacquiao fighting Mikey because it's a common fighter that they both fight. And if we're not seeing these two champions fight, well, we could get a little degree on what's going on, who knocked out who first, who knocked down who first, who finished somebody at a certain round. Something to argue about. Something to go back and forth with, right? So, I have no issue with that at all. Shit. All right, so back to Mayweather. Yeah, I'm all over because I don't have my shit together. So sometimes I'm like that. So Mayweather, you're a businessman going to real estate. You know, you're making a lot of money in real estate. I saw your mansions, beautiful mansions. Everything's going good. It's either you in or you out. Now, if you're doing business with the sport, fine. I don't see nothing wrong with you fighting Khabib. I don't see you fighting McGregor. I have no problem. It's entertainment, okay? There's not a problem. But if you can't run it back with Manny Pacquiao, and he has a whole country behind him, right? And you're telling me about your faculties and your health is your wealth. And get this. People are bitching about Manny Pacquiao fighting McGregor. Well, why can't he have a fight like that, right? You always say, it's business. Well, Manny Pacquiao could do that just like you can, Mayweather. And even if you started it, someone else could do it. I don't got no problem with Clarissa Shields fighting Amanda. I would love to see that fight. I'm not hearing anything about that fight, but I would love to see that fight with Amanda and Clarissa Shields. So you set the trend, but when other people do it, I don't see why your fans gotta complain that Manny Pacquiao is doing with McGregor. I just don't understand it. It shouldn't be a problem. If he wants to do that, he wants to do that. Why he have to drop the belt to do that? He don't have to drop the belt. Okay? He let me tell you why he don't have to drop the belt. Because he reached out to Bob Arum, who blocked the fight again with Terrence Crawford over negotiations. He wanted that fight. He wanted that fight before he wanted Triple G or whatever story went down the line. He wanted that fight before anything. He reached out to Bob Arum. It didn't happen. It didn't work. So why the man have to drop his belt if he's doing something over here? He don't have to drop his belt. The man is passionate and he wants to keep boxing. When he's boxing not because he's broke. I don't know why y'all keep saying it. I mean, the amount of shit that Mayweather's buying. The man don't buy all that shit. Okay? It's quiet as kept. How you gonna be broke if you president of your country? Come on, man. Y'all fucking playing games, man. Y'all come up with all kinds of fucking scenarios. Why Manny Pacquiao don't do this? Why Manny Pacquiao don't do that? And the motherfucking thing I heard that drove me a little nutty, I'm hearing people saying, well, the when Spence said that thing about Manny Pacquiao on Instagram or whatever the fuck it is, and he came back like this, on his GIF on Instagram, and he replied, you know what the story is? Oh, Manny Pacquiao and did that. It was Manny Pacquiao team. Why didn't you hear that when Bud and Spence was going at it on Twitter or Instagram, and then all of a sudden, who popped up? Manny Pacquiao. He popped up, yes? But I didn't hear that story about, oh, it wasn't Manny Pacquiao. It was Manny Pacquiao's team. I'll tell you something, man. If my team did that, you think I don't have a clue what my team's saying about me? Listen, it's my fucking Instagram, okay? Regardless, no one speaks for me. And if they do, they got to get the A-OK from me. Yo, Manny, can I reply back to Spence with this? Sure. Bingo. Team did it, okay? So stop this foolishness, man. Stop this foolishness, man. It ain't going to work. It's not going to work, yo. Y'all coming up with excuses for all kind of fucking dumb shit, man. I'm irritable now. I gotta go. I'm getting irritable, but there's one thing I want to get off my chest, yo. Alright? You know, this thing with Manny Pacquiao and Mayweather, this could go from generation to generation, alright? And this thing with Michael Pacquiao and Mayweather's son, let's keep it between Mayweather, Floyd, Pacquiao. Okay, let's keep it between Emmanuel Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather. All right, but if those two young people want to battle it out, fine. Let them battle out in some of that good stuff, with some of that hot sauce language. Yo, it's all good. It doesn't matter. All right, but this thing between Manny Pacquiao and Floyd, there's a lot of shit going on behind the scenes, and I feel like there's a lot of shit that a lot of people are not knowing when it comes to Spence. and Manny Pacquiao and things not happening. But when it comes to Manny Pacquiao and Floyd, it's always going to have this back and forth competition. So here, this is what I want to do. This is what I want to do, okay? Instead of seeing Michael Pacquiao and Floyd's son go at it with the hip-hop and the lyrics and all this bullshit, I would like to see Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao one-on-one ball up. Yes, sir. I want y'all to ball up. Ball up. I'm not talking about 3-on-3, 2-on-2, and then you up there making jump shots and then you win and all this shit. No. One-on-one, I want to see Manny Pacquiao ball with Mayweather. Is that a problem with that? Is that a problem with that? Instead of putting all that pressure on the Suns and all this nonsense. I'm listening to all these videos of Michael Pacquiao. He's very talented and everything. But if all of a sudden Mayweather's son comes out with a song that we don't even know if he wrote or not, and it's better, we're going to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. All right? So leave this. Let's leave it to the fathers, yo. Listen, if I'm not going to get a boxing match, I want to see at least one-on-one a ball game. Okay, Manny Pacquiao balls, he balling. Floyd, I saw you the other day balling with some guy in his 50s or some shit, I don't know. And you're doing your jump shots and you're looking nice and shit. No, one on one with Manny Pacquiao, right? And Floyd, yeah, charity, something, man. Because we're not gonna see a fight again, right? Y'all in the same era. So let's see that. All right. Let's see something there. We could get some views from that. All right. All right. I'm done. I'm out. But I'm going to close like this. All right.
And the millions watching like this, around the world from the capital city of the United States of America, Washington, D.C. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to.
When I'm in the ring, they call me the king. I think I'm becoming like Pacquiao. I'm thinking like Manny, we coming in handy. We giving you something to chat about. I'm here to bring in the bag. Whoa. I never live with a mask. Whoa. I wouldn't come in the ring because I would go in with a wicked attack. When I'm in the ring, they call me the king. I think I'm becoming like Pacquiao. I'm thinking like Manny, we coming in handy. We giving you something to chat about. I'm here to bring in the bag. Whoa. I never live with a mask. Whoa. I wouldn't come in the ring because I would go in with a wicked attack.
Feeling myself, get it together. I never take else. Doing much better for me, no one else. Me alone, I'll be proof of myself. Hey. King of the jungle, 12 chain rounds and I'm ready to rumble.
That's the speed. Chain, so that's the speed.
Everybody wanna be true. Everybody wanna be you.
Never gonna be you. Speed.
Never ever gonna
put work.
Cash flow, we be swimming in. The track still got me running in. My mind, she got me spinning in. My life, she let me hit it in.
When I'm in the ring, they call me the king. I think I'm becoming like Pacquiao.
Yeah, I'm out, nigga.
Whoa. I never live with a mask. Whoa. I wouldn't come in the ring because I would go in with a wicked attack. When I'm in the ring, they call me the king. I think I'm becoming like Pacquiao. I'm thinking like Manny, we coming in handy. We giving you something to chat about. I'm here to bring in the bag.
Whoa.
I never live with a mask.
Whoa.
I wouldn't come in the ring because I would go in with a wicked attack. I'm in the